Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Angular MultiSelect Dropdown component. Imagine that you want to choose your favorite sports names from a collection. Surely, you would like to select multiple names from that list, not just one. In this case, the Angular MultiSelect Dropdown from Syncfusion would fit perfectly. It allows you to choose multiple items from a huge collection and displays the selected items on the UI. You can also bind hierarchical data to it, filter and group its items, as well as customize its UI with templates. Now, let me show you the steps to create an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool. I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code. I view the output result on any of the supported browsers like Google Chrome. First, I need to install the Angular CLI in my machine using this command. npm install -g at angular/cli. As I have already installed Angular CLI in my machine, I am skipping this step here. Next, I am going to create a new Angular project, so I use this command, ng new project name. I have named my project Angular Example. This will create an Angular project along with its dependencies. Now, let me navigate to the project folder. To use the Syncfusion Angular MultiSelect dropdown, I need to install the Syncfusion Angular dropdowns package using this command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-dropdowns --save. This will install the Angular dropdowns package along with its dependencies. Now, I will open this application in Visual Studio Code. The first thing I need to do here is navigate to the app module file and import the MultiSelect module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular dropdowns package and register it within the imports array of the ng module section. Next, open the main TS file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Then, register the Syncfusion Angular trial license key by using the register license method. The Syncfusion Angular license key registration is required starting with the 2022 Volume 1 release. Now, I will make changes in the app component HTML file. Here, I will clear this default content and add the Angular MultiSelect dropdown component using the tag EJS MultiSelect. Next, I need to populate the data for the MultiSelect dropdown, so let me open the app component file and define the object variable local data and assign an array of objects that holds two fields, ID and game. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the MultiSelect dropdown component. So, let me define the variable data fields and map this game field to the text property and ID field to the value property. Then, I assign this local data to the data source property and data fields to the fields property. This data source contains a list of sports, so let me define placeholder property with the value select a game, which will be displayed in the MultiSelect dropdown component as a description. Along with this, I also need to define CSS for MultiSelect dropdown, so let me import the material theme from static assets in style.css file. Here, I added the CSS references for all the dependent components like buttons, inputs, pop-ups, and lists. Now, I will save this application and run it using the command ng serve. When you look at the Angular MultiSelect dropdown, you can see the sports name listed here. You can also notice that the MultiSelect dropdown displays the short description, select a game. Here, by default, the pop-up width will automatically adjust according to the MultiSelect dropdown input element's width, and the height auto-adjusts according to the height of the pop-up list items. To set a custom height and width, I define the pop-up height to 200 pixels and pop-up width to 250 pixels. Then, I add class attribute for this division element and define CSS style for this class within this style.css file. So now, look at the MultiSelect dropdown component where the pop-up is displayed with a custom height and width. If I want to bind a remote data source to the component, then I need to use the data manager. The data manager acts as a gateway between the MultiSelect dropdown and the data source. It also uses queries to interact with both local and remote data sources. So, as a first step, I import the data manager and required adapter from the EJ2 data repository. Second, I define an instance named remote data for the data manager with the properties URL, adapter, and cross-domain. In the URL, I use the already available remote URL service, which retrieves the list of data through post action and then binds the data to the multi-select dropdown. Also, I set Web API adapter here, as the URL is assigned the existing Web API service. The cross-domain option is set to true to allow the cross-origin domain request. Here, this remote URL contains four fields, namely first name, employee ID, designation, and country. Now, I need to map the remote data source fields, first name to the text property, and employee ID to the value property, inside this data fields variable. Next, I am going to fetch first 10 records from the employee table, so let me write the query by defining a variable data query of type query. Here, I create a query instance and use select command to fetch the first 10 records from the remote data source with the fields first name and employee ID. Also, I need to import this query from the EJ2 data repository to access this query class. Then, I assign this instances of remote data to the data source property and data query to the query property of the multi-select dropdown component. I have set employee names as data source, so let me change the placeholder property value to select a name. And now, you can see the multi-select dropdown shows employee names over here. The component displays data items in the data source order. To reorder data items in ascending or descending order, I need to use the sort order property. To demonstrate, I am going to sort these items in descending order. I define the property sort order and set its value to descending. So here, data items in the multi-select dropdown are in descending order. In this video, we have seen how to create an Angular project using Visual Studio Code and add a Syncfusion Angular MultiSelect dropdown to it. Also, we have seen how to load JSON and remote data sources in the MultiSelect dropdown. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite, with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.